In this session, we'll discuss about the coordinate system, in particular rectangular coordinate system. So in rectangular coordinate system, we have three mutually perpendicular axes which are given by x, y and z. So this is the origin. So any point P, let's say point which is given by 3, 4, 5, is given by, so here here this is the x coordinate, which is 3 in this case. This is the y coordinate, which is 4, and this is the z coordinate, which is 5. So here x is equal to 3 means it is the distance of the point P from the yz plane. This is the yz plane, and y is equal to 4 means it is the distance of the point P from the zx plane, and z is equal to 5 means it is the distance of the point P from xy plane. So here the unit vectors are pointing in x, y and z directions. So the unit vectors have a magnitude equal to unity, and they point in the direction in which the particular coordinate increases. Let us consider a point A which is given by x, y and z. That is, this is x, y and z. So let us obtain a new point B by incrementing x by dx, y by dy and z by dz. That is, we will give differential increments. So we will be getting a new point. This is incrementing in x direction by dx, and this is incrementing in y direction by dy, and this is incrementing in z direction by dz. So this is the new point B, which is given by x plus dx, y plus dy and z plus dz. So here we can construct a volume element . So this is the point P and this is the point A. And this length is dx, this is dy and this is dz. So now we can see that the displacement vector from A to B, that is dl, is given by bx ax, because we are incrementing from A by dx in x direction and by dy in y direction and by dz in z direction. Also, we can see that the volume of this element, the differential volume element, is given by dx, dy and dz. And these are the differential surfaces. So this is ds1, this is ds2. Please note that the differential surfaces are vector quantities, and this is ds3. So here ds1, vector ds1, it has the area dy into dz. And it is pointing in x direction. So you have to remember that the differential surfaces are vector quantities whose direction is the outward normal. So here this vector is pointing in the outward direction. So this is the direction of the differential surface ds1. Similarly, here ds2, so here it is this area is dx into dz. And it is pointing in y direction. Similarly, this differential surface ds3 has area dx and dy. And it is pointing in z direction.